Hello, my dear friends and my dear students. I welcome you to my YouTube channel. Before myself, Thirunagaram Manohar, Department of Mathematics, University College of Science, Tumkur, Karnataka. My mobile number 6302026237 and 8985084319. My dear friends, if you not subscribe my YouTube channel yet, please subscribe my YouTube channel as Thirunagaram Manohar, Thirunagaram Manohar, Thirunagaram Manohar. Please subscribe my YouTube channel as Thirunagaram Manohar. Like this video and share to your friends, as well as write your comments on my comment box. Okay, my dear friends, I came to here to introduce number theory. In that number theory, BSc of which is a Tumkur in under Tumkur University 6.2A number theory, under number theory unit 3, I want to give complete guide course. Under complete guide course, part 1. Under part 1, my dear friends, before going to part 1, first 2. So, under unit 3, which topic we want to cover? Please refer these topics. Multiple, first of all, we want to discuss about multiplicative functions. Next, second, next and beautiful topic is the sum and the number of divisors. This is a very, very interesting and beautiful topic. Next, and also most interesting topic, the Mobius inversion formula. Mobius inversion formula. Next, the greatest integer function, as well as Euler's phi function. Next, Euler's generalization of Fermat's theorem. And last but least, properties of phi function. This is the topics we want to cover under unit 3 of number 36.2A of BSc Tumkur University. My dear friends, if you want to refer, we want to refer these topics, so I recommended these books. First of all, David M. Burton. Next, Elementary Number Theory, 6th edition. Next, David M. Burton, Number Theory, Elementary of Number Theory, 6th edition is newly released. Next, Tata McGraw-Hill's edition, Indian representation, reprint 2007. Next, one more book I referred, Richard E. Klima. Next, Niels Sigmund, Ernest Stinger's Applications of Abstract Algebra with Maple, CRC Press, Boca Raton 2000. So these two books I recommended. If you want to refer this six number theory, please refer these books. Especially, we are following this David M. Burton. Okay, my dear friends, in the number theory 6.2A number theory under unit 3. Okay, first of all, what do you want to discuss means? First of all, definition of multiplicative function. Definition of multiplicative function. Multiplicative function. This one we want to discuss first of all. See, my dear friends, what is meant by multiplicative function means? Multiplicative function. Okay, very, very important for viewers. This is 2 marks, very, very important. 2 marks, this definition is very important. That one is a function, any function, f from n tends to c, that means natural numbers to complex numbers, defined is said to be multiplicative, is said to be multiplicative if it satisfies two conditions. Multiplicative function, if it satisfies two conditions. what are the two conditions means if M1 or M1 comma M2 belongs to the domain of this function. Domain of this function is what? Natural number. Okay, belongs to the natural number n, and also satisfies GCD of M comma M1 comma M2 is equal to 1. GCD of M1 comma M2 is equal to 1. That means this is nothing but that is M1 and M2 are relatively primes. Relatively primes. This is one condition. Then next one more condition is what? Then f of m1 into m2 is equal to f of m1 into f of m2. These two condition must and should satisfy, then the function is said to be a multiplicative function. See here, once again repeat, multiplicative function means any function f is from natural numbers to complex numbers is said to be a multiplicative function if m1 comma m2 belongs to the domain natural number n and the GCD of m1 comma m2 is equal to 1, that is m1 and m2 are relatively primes, then f of m1 into m2 is equal to f of m1 into f of m2. So when you satisfy these two conditions, this one and this one, then we say that this function is said to be multiplicative function. Okay, my dear friends, if you clear this definition, I will move on to the some example problems, examples on this definition. I will give examples. See here. Examples. Okay, my dear friends, first of all, example 1, let f is from natural numbers to complex numbers. F is from natural numbers to complex numbers is defining. F is from natural numbers to complex numbers is defining. Okay, let us take this function b as one number I am taking. Let m1 is equal to 2 comma m2 is equal to 3. M1 is equal to 2 and m2 is equal to 3 means then we want to check GCD of m1 comma m2 is equal to, that is GCD of 2 comma 3, we all know that this GCD 1, so that's why one condition is which is belongs to the, and this m1 comma m2 belongs to the domain n natural number, 2 and 3 are belongs to the natural number, and the these are the satisfying the relatively prime condition. Relatively prime condition. So next condition we want to check it. Which condition means we want to check which one is this one, f of m1 into m2 is equal to f of m1 into f of m2. Okay, so for this purpose f of 2 into 3 we want to check. 2 into 3 we want to check. So that is equal to f of 2 into 3. F of 2 into 3 is equal to how much? F of 6. According to this definition, that means what I am taking function is here, let f of m is equal to 5 I am taking. F of m is n is equal to 5 I am taking. F of m is equal to 5. So for any value of n, that function value is equal to 5. So this 5 which is belongs to complex numbers. This is 5 belongs to complex number. So see here, see f of 6 means how much? F of 6 according to this function, this value 5. Okay, next what do you want? F of 2 value. F of 2 also 5. Next what do you want? F of 3 we want. F of 3 also, for any value of n, this function value 5. Okay, now we want to check. Now we want to check this function f of m1 into m2 is equal to f of m1 into f of m2. If it is satisfied this condition, then you say that this function, then you say that this function is a multiplicative function on the elbow limit. So for this purpose, we want to check it. F of m1 into m2, that is f of 2 into 3 is equal to f of 2 into f of 3. So that means that, my dear friends, see here, f of 2 into 3 means f of 6. Okay, the f of 6, one more step I want to write. This f of 2, f of 3 also we have to write as it is. Now, we want to apply these all values. F of 6 value much? See here, f of 6 value how much here? According to that, 5, which is equal to f of 2 value how much? F of 2, see here, 5. F of 2 is equal to 5 into f of 3 value how much? 5. F of 3 also 5. So, is 5 is equal to 5 into 5? No. Okay. 5 is not equal to 25. Thus, in conclusion, thus the given function, which one? F of n is equal to 5, f of n is equal to 5 is not a, just a second, is not a multiplicative function, is not a multiplicative function. Okay, my dear friends, like this we want to check whether the given function is a multiplicative function or not, we want to check it. Okay, understand this one. I hope you all understand this example one. I will move on to the next example. That is, second example. See here, let us take second example, my dear friends. Example 2. Let us take this function f of n is equal to n itself. Okay, any n value, that value becomes n. Okay, for this purpose, see here, my dear friends, let f, by the definition of multiplicative function, f is defined from natural numbers to complex numbers. Isn't it? Same values I am taking. Let us take m1 is equal to 2. Why? Because this is easy one. Okay, you all know this. M2 is equal to 3. So, then that means m1 comma m2, which are belongs to the natural number, isn't it? That means 2 comma 3 belongs to natural numbers, and also they are relatively primes. That means GCD of 2 comma 3 is equal to 1. That is, 2 and 3 are relatively primes. 2 and 3 are relatively primes. So, one condition is satisfied. 2 and 3 are relatively primes. Next, what do you want to check? We want to check which one? We want to check. Next, second condition is what? What? That one? F of m1 into m2 is equal to f of m1 into f of m2. This condition we want to check. For this purpose, we want this value. Okay? So, my dear friends, see here. For this purpose, f of m1 into m2. F of m1 into m2 value how much? F of 2 into 3. See here, my dear friends, here, just a second. F of 2 into 3 is equal to f of 6. According to this definition, f of n is equal to n means f of 6 is equal to how much? 6. F of 6 is equal to 6. Next, what do you want? F of m1 we want. That is, f of 2 we want. According to that definition, f of 2 is equal to 2 and f of 3 value, f of m2 value, f of m2 is equal to, just a second, okay, f of m2 is equal to f of 3 f of 3 how much? 3, my dear friends. Why? Because given function is what? Given function is f of n is equal to n given. So that's why for any value of n, for any value we want to take that function value also n. So my dear friends, like that f of 6 is equal to 6, f of 2 is equal to 2, f of 3 is equal to 3. Now we want to check that condition is what? F of m1 into m2 is equal to f of m1 into f of m2. This condition we want to check, my dear friends. So for this purpose, we want to apply all values. F of m1 means 2 into 3 is equal to f of 2 into this f of m2 means f of 3. So now apply all these values here. F of 2 into 3 is equal to f of 6. F of 6 means how much, my dear friends? F of 6 is equal to 6. So that is equal to f of 2 is equal to how much? Hello? Come and tell me. F of 2 is equal to 2. Very good, very good. Into f of 3 is equal to how much? Okay. My dear friends, f of 3 is equal to 3. So that means is 6 is equal to 6? Yes. 6 is equal to 6. Therefore, thus the given function, thus the given function, what? The given function f of n is equal to n is what? Is a multiplicative function. Is a multiplicative function. Okay, my dear friends, like this way we want to check whether the given function is a multiplicative function or not. We want to check. Okay, my dear friends, I hope you all understood these problems. I will move on to the next topic, that is next one, a totally multiplicative function. Next definition, totally multiplicative function. See, dear friends, totally, today my pen is troubling little bit. Totally multiplicative function definition. Totally multiplicative function. There is a little bit difference between multiplicative function and totally multiplicative function. We all know that multiplicative function means f is from, see here, we all know that multiplicative function means a function from natural numbers to complex numbers is said to be a multiplicative function if it satisfies m1, m2 belongs to n and GCD of m1, m2 is equal to 1, that is m1 and m2 are related ones, then f of m1 into m2 is equal to f of m1 into f of m2. But whereas here, totally multiplicative function, in the totally multiplicative function, same, little bit change. See here, any function, f is from natural numbers to complex number is said to be a totally multiplicative function. Totally multiplicative function. Totally multiplicative function if satisfies only one condition. If satisfies only one condition, that is m1 comma m2 belongs to the domain n, domain of this function n, and last condition of multiplicative function, what is that? F of m1 into m2 is equal to f of m1 into f of m2 only. This condition, only one condition, if only one condition satisfies, then you say that function is said to be a multiplicative, totally multiplicative function. Totally multiplicative function. I hope you all understood this definition. I will move on to the examples. Example, see here my dear friends. Okay, first one, f of n is equal to d of n. That means divisor of n. Divisor of n. See here, divisor of n means, we all understood, divisor of n. If, first of all understood, divisor of n means, if you take 4 number, that is what are the divisor of 4? 1 is a divisible by 4. 2 is a divisible by 4. 3 is not divisible by 4. 4 is the divisible by 4. So that's why d of 4, how much? D of 4 is equal to number of divisors. 1, 2, 3. So 3 numbers divisible. So that's why these are the divisors of 4. 3 divisors. So d of 4 is equal to 3. So d of n means divisors of the natural number, divisors of the integer n. Okay, my dear friends. So directly I am taking that one. Let n is equal to 4. N is equal to 4 means this function f of 4 is equal to what? Divisor of 4. Divisor of 4 how much? 3. This 3 which is 4, which is, this 4 belongs to natural number, isn't it? Domain natural number. And this 3, 3 plus 0 into I, 0 into I which is belongs to complex number. So that's why that function is defined. That function is defined. This is one example. Next one, second example. Let us take n is equal to 20. Let us take n is equal to 20. Okay, my dear friends. The all divisors of 20 are what? 20 divisors in agate. 1 is a divisor of 20. 2 is a divisor of 20. Next, very good. 3 is not a divisor of 20. 4 is a divisor of 20. 5 is a divisor of 20. 6 is not divisor of 20. Why? Because 6 is not exactly divisible by 20. So that's why 6 is not a divisor of 20. Next, my dear friends, 10 also divisor of 20. 20 also divisor of 20. So my dear friends, what are the divisor of 20? Therefore, f of n is equal to divisor of n. F of n is equal to divisor of n. How much? Divisor of n is equal to how much? That means divisor of 20. Divisor of 20. See here, my dear friends. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So, divisor of 20, how much? 6. Okay, we all know that. This n belongs to the natural number n. And this 6 also 6 plus 0 into I. 0 into I. So, which is belongs to complex number. So, that's why this is one of the example of the totally multiplicative function. Okay, my dear friends. I hope you all understood multiplicative function and totally multiplication. I will move on to the one problem question. See here. This is very, very important for 2 marks. Okay, check whether the function, f of n is equal to divisor of n, f of n is equal to divisor of function is totally multiplicative function or not for which values? For m1, they will give m1 directly. m1 is equal to 10 and m2 is equal to 2. for these values, this function is a totally multiplicative function or not, that one we want to check. This function, whether the function f of n is equal to divergent divisor of n is a totally multiplicative function or not, we want to check. We want to check this one. For these two values, for this two, m1 is equal to 10 and m2 is equal to 2. Okay, my dear friends, question understand, I will move on to the problem solution. See here, what is solution? What is given first of all? M1 is equal to 10 and M2 is equal to how much is given? 2 is given. Now we want to check, or now we have to check. What do you want to check? We want to check the function. Which function? F of n is equal to divisor of n is a totally multiplicative function. Totally multiplicative function or not? This one we want to check. Totally multiplicative function. So for this purpose, enough to prove, that is f of m1 into m2 is equal to f of m1 into m2. This one we want to prove. Enough to prove. So, my dear friends, f of m1 is equal to m2. So, for this purpose, we want to find this LHS and RHSL value. LHS, left hand side. That means what? F of m1 into m2 is equal to, what is that? F of m1 means how much? Here, m1 is equal to 10 now. Into m2 value 2, f of 20. This one, 10 into 2, how much? F of 20. According to this definition, f of n is equal to what? Divisor of n. So that's why, according to the definition of f of 20, that is what? Divisor of 20. Divisor of 20, how much? Divisor of 20, 6. So this is the LHS. LHS how much? 6. Next, my dear friends, what do you want to check? RHS we want. RHS is equal to what? F of m1 into f of m2 we want to check. My dear friends, f of m1 means f of 10 into f of m2 means f of 2. See, my dear friends, according to the definition of what is the definition? F of n is equal to divisor of n. Your problem is given. This function, how is given? F of n is equal to divisor of n is given. So according to that, f of 10 means what? Divisor of 10. Divisor of 10 into f of 2 means divisor of 2. Okay, my dear friends, value you want to apply. Divisor of 10. 10 divisors how many? 4. So divisor of 10, see here, 1 is a divisor of 10, 2 is a divisor of 10, 3 is not divisor, 4 is not divisor, 5 is a divisor of 10, 10 is a divisor of 10. How many are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4 divisor of 10 is 4. Next divisor of 2, 2. So that is equal to 8. This is RHS. This is RHS. Is 6 is equal to 8? No. 6. Therefore, 6 is not equal to 8. That implies LHS is not equal to RHS. LHS is not equal to RHS. That means the given function, which one? F of n is equal to divisor of n is not a totally multiplicative function for which value? For m1 is equal to 10 and m2 is equal to 2. For these values, this function is not a totally multiplicative function. Okay, my dear friends, I hope you all understood. I will move on to the next topic, that is small note I want to discuss here. Small note. See here, my dear friends, which one is satisfies both the multiplicative function and totally multiplicative function means f of n is equal to n is both satisfies is both sorry my pen is troubling me a little bit today both satisfies multiplicative and totally multiplicative functions. Okay, f of n is equal to n is both satisfies multiplicative function as well as totally multiplicative function. Okay, my dear friends. Okay, I hope you are all understood this one. I will move on to the next one. That one beautiful theorem we want to discuss. Beautiful theorem, first theorem. Theorem 1 we want to discuss. This is very very important for 5 marks. For 5 marks. See here, statement. Statement they will give. If f of n is a multiplicative function, f of n is a multiplicative function, then see here, my dear friends, capital F of n is equal to summation d divides n F of d is also a multiplicative function. Is also a multiplicative function. Multiplicative function. See, my dear friends, this is the theorem. First of all, you must understand this one. If f of n is a multiplicative function, means all multiplicative function we want to use. Which are the multiplicative function? Two conditions are there. If f1 and m2 are related prime and f of m1 into m2 is equal to f of m1 into f of m2. That two conditions, wherever you want to use. So then, capital F of n is what? F of d means d is a divisor of the n, all divisor of n, d is the divisor of n, then that function value of divisors sum maadidre barod one function ki equal maadtare, this function is equal to multiplicative function. Once again I will repeat, small f of n is a multiplicative function anta avaru kottidare. Neven prove maadbekandre divisor of n yenenido adike function value apply maadi sum maadidre baro value ಒಂದು ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಎಫ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನ್ ಇಂದ ಡಿನೋಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರೆ ಈ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಏನಂತ ಪ್ರೂವ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಮಲ್ಟಿಪ್ಲಿಕೇಟಿವ್ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಅಂತ ಪ್ರೂವ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಮಲ್ಟಿಪ್ಲಿಕೇಟಿವ್ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಅಂತ ಪ್ರೂವ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಓಕೆ ಮೈ ಡಿಯರ್ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ಐ ಹೋಪ್ ಯು ಆಲ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟುಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಮೂವ್ ಆನ್ ಟು ದಿ ಪ್ರೂಫ್ ಓಕೆ ದಿಸ್ ಪ್ರೂಫ್ ಲೆಟ್ ಎಂ ಒನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಎಂ ಟು ಬಿಲಾಂಗ್ಸ್ ಟು ದಿ ನ್ಯಾಚುರಲ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಎನ್ ಸಚ್ ದಟ್ directly I am taking they are relatively primes. GCD of m1 comma m2 is equal to 1 is equal to 1. So what do you want to prove? Claim. What do you want to prove means capital F of m1 into m2 is equal to capital F of m1 into capital F of m2. This one we want to prove. For this purpose, there is two cases we want to prove. First, we show that divisor of M we want to take. That M is equal to, I am taking as a product, M1 into M2. This M, I am taking M1 into M2. If and only if there exist two integers, what? D1 and D2, such that how they are means such that D1 divides M and sorry, D1 divides M1 and D2 divides M2. D2 divides M2. Like that, we want to choose two integers. See here, my dear friends, what do you want to prove first of all means? This one we want to prove first of all. This from here to here we want to prove first of all. First, we show that D divides M if and only if there exist two integers D1 and D2 such that D1 divides M1 and D2 divides M2. This one we want to prove. Very, very easy one. Divisor rule follow away. Divisor rule follow away. First condition if and only if case. So that's why both sides we want to prove both sides. So first of all what you want to take? Assume that D divides M. So this case D divides M anta takobeku yen prove madbeku neevu D1 divides M1 and D2 divides M2 anta prove madbekagutte. So that's why my dear friends let us take for this purpose take D1 is equal to what? D divisor of M1 anta we want to take. Divisor of M1. According to the definition, this one what? Divisor of M1 andre. So that means D1 divides M1. Tanu bari bodu. So next D2 is equal to divisor of M2. Like that we want to take it. That implies this is nothing but D2 divides M2. Okay, my dear friends. D1 divides M1 and D2 divides Pandida. In one case I do. Next, it's conversely we want to prove. It's conversely, my dear friends, just a second. I will open new page. Just a second. Okay, my dear friends, see here. See, my dear friends, here one case is over. Next, reverse case. If we want to choose D1 divides M1 and D2 divides M2, then what do you want to prove? D divides M1 and prove. D divides M1 and prove. For this purpose, conversely, assume that what you want to assume this one here to here D1 divides M1 and D2 divides M2 anta assume madbeku. What you want to prove? D divides M1 M anta prove madbeku. For that purpose I want to write more sentence. M1 and M2 has a divisor M1 and M2 has a divisor, say D1. That means M1 has a divisor D1, M2 has a divisor D2, respectively. That means what? M1 has a divisor D1 and M2 has a divisor D2. Like that, we want to assume that. What do you want to prove? D divides M anta prove madidre saku, a case complete agutte. For this purpose, that means what? This means D1 divides M1 anta. Idu mathematical step. D2 divides M2 anta. D2 divides M2. We all know that D1 divides M1 and D2 divides M2 andre. Eradu product madidivi andre D1 into D2. Product madbekandre divisor so ondu product D1 into D2 divides M1 into M2. We all know that D1 D2 means what? D divides M1 into M2 what? M. So that's all, my dear friends, completed. So what do you want to complete? What do you want to prove? Means first one case complete. Capital F of M1 into M2 is equal to capital F of M1 into capital F of M2. Prove madidhi. E case prove aitu. Next in prove madbekandre e condition prove madbeku. Yavudu? Capital F of N is equal to summation D divides N F of N. ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಮಲ್ಟಿಪ್ಲಿಕೇಟಿವ್ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಅಂತ ಪ್ರೂವ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾಗುತ್ತೆ. ಅದಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರ ಈಗ ಏನು ಪ್ರೂವ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಂದ್ರೆ ನೌ ಸಿ ಡಿಯರ್ ಮೈ ಡಿಯರ್ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ನೌ ವಿ ಪ್ರೂವ್ ದಿಸ್ ವಿ ಪ್ರೂವ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಎಫ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಸಮೇಷನ್ ಡಿ ಡಿವೈಡ್ಸ್ ಎನ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಎಫ್ ಆಫ್ ಡಿ ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್ ವಿ ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಪ್ರೂವ್ ದಿಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪರ್ಪಸ್ For this purpose, what do you want to take? This m, n I am taking as m1 into m2. See here, that n I am taking capital m1 into m2. So, is equal to summation d divides m1 into m2. Like that I am taking f of d. We all know this, my dear friends. Capital f of m1 into m2 is equal to what this d also divisor I am taking d also divisor as a product d1 into d2 divides m1 into m2 f of d1 into d2 I am taking first of all m means m1 m2 d and d1 d2 now my dear friends capital f of m1 into m2 is equal to this one summation we want to split this one summation d1 d2 divides m1 m2 means summation d1 divides m1 into summation d2 divides m2 okay isn't it f of d1 into d2 call it as equation 1 so we all know this value how much wow, you all know that these d1 d2 are they one their value capital f of m1 into m2 value sum are the divisor of m1 one we all know this one so capital f of m1 into m2 is equal to one means what do you want d1 comma d2 are relatively primes d1 comma d2 are relatively primes okay this one we don't want what do you want to prove d1 d2 m1 m2 are relatively prime anta new prove madbeku adikoskara just a second my dear friends one more page I want to open just a second yes now comes to this one ಎಸ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಏನ್ ಪ್ರೂವ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕಂದ್ರೆ ಸಪೋಸ್ ಜಿಸಿಡಿ ಆಫ್ ಡಿ ಒನ್ ಕಾಮ ಡಿ ಟು ಮೋರ್ ದನ್ ಒನ್ ಎ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಇದೆ ಅಂತ ಅನ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋಣ ಸೊ ಜಿಸಿಡಿ ಆಫ್ ಡಿ ಒನ್ ಕಾಮ ಡಿ ಟು ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಎ ಅಂತ ಅನ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ರೆ ಅಕಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದ ಡಿವೈಸರ್ಸ್ ಡೆಫಿನೇಷನ್ ದಿಸ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಇಸ್ ಹೌ ಮಚ್ ಎ ಡಿವೈಡ್ಸ್ ಡಿ ಒನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಎ ಡಿವೈಡ್ಸ್ d2 okay a divides d1 and a divide d2 and also the previously we en anta gottide d1 divides m1 and d2 divides m2 anta gottide d2 divides m2 yake f is a multiplicative function anta small f d2 divides m2 anta gottide this implies eradu club madidre ಎರಡು ಕ್ಲಬ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಎ ಡಿವೈಡ್ಸ್ ಡಿ ಒನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಡಿ ಒನ್ ಡಿವೈಡ್ಸ್ ಎಂ ಒನ್ ಅಂತ ಕ್ಲಬ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಡಿ ಒನ್ ಡಿ ಒನ್ ಸೇಮ್ ಇದೆ ಸೊ ದಟ್ಸ್ ವೈ ಎ ಡಿವೈಡ್ಸ್ ಎಂ ಒನ್ ಆಗತ್ತೆ ಅಂಡ್ ಈ ಎರಡು ಕ್ಲಬ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ವಿ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಈ ಎರಡು ಕ್ಲಬ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ವಿ ಎ ಡಿವೈಡ್ಸ್ ಡಿ ಟು ಅಂಡ್ ಡಿ ಎ ಡಿವೈಡ್ಸ್ ಡಿ ಟು ಅಂಡ್ ಡಿ ಟು ಡಿವೈಡ್ಸ್ ಎಂ ಟು ಎರಡು ಕ್ಲಬ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಎ ಡಿವೈಡ್ಸ್ ಎಂ ಟು ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಸೊ ಮೈ ಡಿಯರ್ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್ A divides M1 and A divides M2 means what? M1 comma M2 are not GCD equals to 1. GCD 1 anta bartta ide. But this one don't want. What do you want? GCD of, sorry, in one step I want to write. This means what? GCD of M1 comma M2 is equal to A. This is, that means this is a contradiction to our hypothesis what? is equal to 1 ki idu contradiction that means not equals to 1 so that's why my dear friends This is the contradiction. This is contradiction to our assumption. Our assumption is what? M1, M2 is equal to 1. That GCD of M1, M2 is equal to 1. That is our assumption. This assumption is what? Contradiction. So that's why, therefore, my dear friends, therefore, the function f of n is a multiplicative function, is a multiplicative function, and that condition is what? Capital F of m1 into m2 is equal to summation d1 divides m1 into summation d2 divides m2 into capital F of small f of d1 into d2 n agathe nodbidana ila. So my dear friends, summation, this one we want to split. Summation d1 divides m1 into summation d2 divides m2. This one, according to the multiplicative function, f of m1 into m2 means f of m1 into f of m2. So that's why f of d1 into d2 means f of d1 into f of d2. F of d1 into f of d2. See here, my dear friends, this one expanded. F of d1 into d2 is nothing but f of d1 into f of d2. Now, we want to write all d1 terms at one place. So, my dear friends, see here, summation d1 divides m1 into f of d1, right at one place. Next, summation d2 divides m2 into f of d2, right at one place. We all know that according to the summation definition, this value how much? This value how much? Yeah, come on, tell me. Capital F of m1 into this value how much? Capital F of m2. Okay, my dear friends, capital F of m1 into m2 is equal to what you get? Capital F of m1 into m2. Capital F of m2. Like this way, in the two cases we want to prove. I hope, my dear friends, you all understood this theorem. Very, very important, this theorem. If you understood this theorem, I will move on to the stop this video session. Okay, my dear friends, before stopping, please subscribe my YouTube channel as Thirunagaram Manohar, TIRUNAGARAMMANOHAR. Please subscribe my YouTube channel, like this video and share it to your friends, as well as write your comments on my comment box. Okay, my dear friends, and share to your friends. Thank you. Thank you, one and all.